Well, hello there, beautiful world, and welcome to Monday Mindset. Let's get ready to start our week with a beautiful intention by taking in a deep breath and exhale. Take in another breath and push that oxygen out, all the way out, and bring in another nice life revitalizing breath. Today I was inspired to read a saying out of Yogananda's Book of Sayings. A devotee was stressed because fellow disciples seemed to be making greater spiritual progress than he, and the master said, "Keep your eyes on the big platter instead of on your own dish, thinking of what you didn't get instead of what has been given to you." What does that mean? I feel what the master is trying to say is that you miss so many blessings if you're focused on what's going on around you. And then when you try to decipher where you are, how successful you are, whether it's emotionally, physically, wealth, job, love, life, how can you possibly focus on what it is that's going inside of you, what blessings you have, and how to motivate your own self? What does success mean to you? Do you value and place your value on other people instead of who and what you are? Are you not incredible? Are you not perfect? If you're not where you want to be, then do something about it. Focus on what you want to do and what you want to be. Set a game plan. Write some things down on a piece of paper. But do not compare what you do or do not have to what other people have. You don't know what they did to earn it. You don't know what hell they walked through to get there. You know, it's so important that we place the value that we are on our own self. Focus. Focus on what you have. What is your own health like? Maybe you don't have the job that you want to have, but you're certainly capable of getting it. But if you start evaluating the things in your life based on what other people have, then you're going to set yourself up for failure. And we don't want to do that. Motivation starts within. Motivation is the self. Motivate yourself by what you want, by what you see you can achieve. Because when you can see it and dream it, you can achieve it. Walt Disney was a wonderful example of that. Look what he did. He transformed a little piece of land into the most magical place on earth. Transformation is key here, everyone. It's what I tell myself every day. I am capable of the transformation that I want to make in my own life, but I'm going to do it for me. I tell my husband, "You can't love me enough for me to love myself. And I am so blessed. I'm so lucky that you love me, but I'm even luckier and I'm even more blessed because I love me as much or more than you can possibly love me." And I'm sharing this wisdom with you today because that's one of the most difficult things that we have to overcome, is learning to love ourselves, embrace what we have. And once you can do that and focus on that, that's unconditional love. That is pure unconditional love. You don't have to wait for someone else to say you're beautiful or you're handsome or you've done a good job. Take the time to pat yourself on the back. Take the time to look in the mirror. I don't care if you just woke up or if you had a long day of work, and say, "You know what? You look great. I'm proud of you." So today's motivation is get out there and rock it this week. Whatever it is you're going to do, make sure you do it with pride, joy, love, and know that you are capable of doing and being anything you set your mind to. Motivational Monday, Mindset Monday. Don't wait for the world to recognize you and pat you on the back. Because once you can do it for yourself, you can accomplish anything. And you're going to shine. How could you not? You are baby gods. You are the child of God, Mother, Father, God, that which created everything. You are a creator. So this week, start every day off taking a deep breath in and exhaling all that air from the night, from just laying there, and blow it out and bring in fresh new oxygen into your lungs. Now you can hear a dog barking here in the background. Today I decided, you know what? I'm going to step outside and I'm going to bring some nice, new, fresh oxygen into my lungs. Because that's the way I want to start my morning today. I want to bring some newness in. I want to focus on what's on my plate. I'm not going to worry and stress about what's ahead of me. I'm just going to take it one step at a time. And if I have goals that I need to meet, things I need to do, I'm going to go in and I'm going to write them down on a piece of paper. And I'm going to accomplish what I can. And I'm not going to knock myself or hurt myself if I don't get everything done that I wanted to set out to do. Because I'm going to bask in the perfection that I am. I'm going to recognize my plate is perfect the way it is. Your plate is perfect the way it is. And quite frankly, we are all perfect, even those that can't see it. But more importantly, it's not up to us to show others what they are or what they are not. It is our own sole responsibility to be the best that we can be, to feel the best that we can, to acknowledge how important, how loved, and how wonderful we are. So I want to bless you and say, have the best week you can possibly have. And if you have a moment where it's a downer, then just take a breath and acknowledge your perfection. And this too shall pass. But let's create and let's motivate and let's not think about anyone else's plate except our own. This is Pastor Reverend Lorena Pyle with First Spiritualist Church. Please like, share, and subscribe. And share this motivation with family, friends, and everyone you love. I love you all. God bless. And create well, my friends. Bye for now.